Right, okay, so welcome back to last month. This happened. I hope you all had a good month. My month has been all right, except for my downstairs neighbours trying to get me evicted for some reason, which is very epic, and I'm having a lot of fun dealing with that. But something that's helped me cope through this tough time is the YouTube channel Jokers TV, the only channel in existence to still upload hood pranks in the year 2019. I'm pretty sure I mentioned them in my last episode of last month this happened, probably for some other, like, fucking stupid prank they did. But they come out with a new prank, and I think we should just get straight into this one. Jesus, that is a shit intro. Like, genuinely, one of them default Minecraft intros would have probably done a better job. But anyway, let's get into seeing what the prank's about.
I'm gonna go out to people and tell them straight up, yeah, you look like virgins, okay?
Oh, okay, that sounds fantastic. Like, you really shouldn't be going around calling people virgins. It's really mean. Like, here's a couple of genuine tweets I found last month that show the true effects of calling someone a virgin. If I can be serious for a second, can you all stop using the virgin meme? Because that shit is just genuinely fucking annoying now. I feel like it gets to the point where I'm being referred to by virgin more than as a human fucking being. Maybe it's time for this to die permanently. Yeah, guys, don't call people virgins. It's no laughing matter.
I don't mean to offend anyone. So big up every single virgin.
I'm glad us virgins are finally getting some respect. Like, you saved yourself there, mate. If you didn't say that, you'd have probably got beaten up in the street by a mob of angry virgins. Also, while we're on the topic of virgins, I'm just gonna put this here for a sec.
I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. You look like a virgin, fam.
What do you mean I look like a virgin?
Bro, are you on a mask?
Your mum looks like a virgin. That's like one step up from calling someone's mum gay. This video is just like old school Xbox Live, but in real life.
Are you a virgin or not, bro?
My mum will tump you down, you know.
I'll tump you down, you know. What? Like, I've received a multitude of different threats over the internet in my time, but I've never had someone tell me they'll tump me down. What does that even mean? All right, the definitions of it are: one, a small rounded hill or mound, or a clump of trees, shrubs, or grass.
Bro.
What the fuck? What was that cut? What could have possibly happened between them two clips? Like, he didn't really react overly badly when he was called a virgin, so but what did he say?
So to stop here, well, basically, bro, I'm not gonna lie to you, I saw you from there.
He says as he points towards the cameraman.
More like a virgin than me.
Me?
Yeah, man.
Bro, I just saw you. You look like a virgin.
I'm sorry, but if this guy can't see the camera, then he's fucking blind. Like, he even keeps making eye contact with the camera.
Yo, all of you look like virgins, you know?
You fucking don't.
What are
you calling a virgin, bro?
What? I don't mean to be rude.
Oh, hang on. He's got AirPods in. He's a confirmed not virgin. We saw the same group of guys 30 minutes later with more of their friends, so I decided to prank him too. How is this a prank? This isn't a prank. You're just going up to people and calling them virgins.
You look like a virgin, man.
What?
You look like a virgin. I saw you from that. You look like a virgin, bro. I don't mean to be
my
rude.
My dickhead, bro.
I don't mean to be rude.
Hey, man, them.
Oh, shit.
Okay, now, do you know how I know that this prank is fake? It's not because the camera is, like, in obvious positions that anyone should be able to see. It's because nobody has ever summoned their friends by saying, "Oi, Mandem."
Oi, Mandem!
As if it's some kind of fucking Assassin's Creed Brotherhood whistle. Now, the comments section on this video is pretty brain dead. Like, who would have guessed? It's somehow even worse than mine. Like, half of them aren't even, like, actual English. Can you do stealing people drink again? 225 likes. You look like getting beat up Aria in it. And then we got the comment, do the N-word prank. But anyway, moving on from that. 21 Savage, Atlanta rapper, really from UK, says US immigration. So yeah, I mean, I don't really know what else I could say about that, but Twitter went a bit mad over it. When 21 Savage said, got a house in the hills, doc. This way, 21 Savage needed a 12-car garage. 21 Savage, after everybody clowned on him for being from the UK.
I live in Smethwick, Birmingham. If you want the fucking brawl, come down to Smethwick, ask for Danny G, I'll come out of my house and I'll break your fucking legs.
But anyway, on to the next topic. I found this video last month and it's only got about 1,000 views. But it's a song about Tesco. Not really sure why someone's put this into existence, but anyway, we're going to take a look at it.
T to the E.
What event in this man's life pushed him to make a rap about Tesco? Like, what is there even to rap about? I mean, in fairness, Tesco are real ones. No matter how shit the economy gets, they never change the price of their £3 meal deal. And I've got to respect them for that. Also, I just got to appreciate that watermark. Like, this whole video just looks like it was made in fucking MS Paint.
Yeah, their shares drop, but no, they're gonna grow. It's the Tesco gang.
The Tesco gang. Right then. Bringing off thousands of stores nationwide. Some of them have even got a cafe inside. This just sounds like an ad for Tesco. Like, have they paid you? Because Tesco, if you're giving out money to make raps, just throw some money my way. I'll do it better than him. And last year they won an award for charity. B to the E, S to the co. World's best shop. The people in the back are just trying to go about their weekly shop, but they got to put up with Gavin from Hull throwing up gang signs in the cereal aisle. But another amazing song that's come out this month is Next Big Thing by Daddy Longneck and Wide Neck, and it's almost as bad as their previous song, which involved Longneck, who looks about 13, slapping some grown woman's ass. I hope to God them tattoos aren't real. I hope to God they're not real. But imagine having lick here on your chest for life. And whatever that is that's on his arm, it just looks like it's been scrawled on with a Sharpie. Yeah, bitch, I'm the next big thing. Shut the fuck up and start this. Now, I don't know what kind of bars I was expecting, but even that was a bit shit from them. Shut the fuck up and suck this big neck. What does that even mean? Like, honestly, I'm a bit concerned for these guys. Like, neither of them really seems to know what they're doing. Like, Wide Neck just looks absent half the time. I don't even think he knows where he is. Wanna know my name? Fuck, but she's too cheap. Mate, what are you on about? You're like 13. Anyway, while doing some research on this Daddy Longneck kid, I found this interview that was uploaded a few days ago, and it's an uncut interview. So for about 80% of the time, it's just him rambling.
How does one go from being so chubby to being as skinny as you are?
Shit, I don't even know. Like, I can't even tell you that. Like, you know, like, fucking, I don't know, like... Never know, you know, like...
I don't... Like, what is he saying? Like, it's as if he's deliberately trying not to be understood. I think he said, I don't know, or some variation of it about four times there, but I'm not too sure. It just sounds like he's fucking croaking.
How old were you when you lost your virginity?
I'd say about 8, 7.
What?
No. 7, 8 years old when you lost your virginity?
Yeah, because, you know, like... Like, you know how it is, like...
No, I don't know how it is. I don't think anyone knows how it is. I'm sorry, but there's no chance this kid was going around laying pipe at 7. That's like the first year of primary school. At that age, I didn't even know what it was. I was too busy collecting match attacks. But anyway, moving on to something else that actually happened this month. It was only a couple of days ago, I think. Trisha Paytas uploaded the video, Why David Dobrik is a Horrible Human Being. Now, David Dobrik is probably one of my favourite creators on the site. So I was very curious to see what he did, and as it turns out, he didn't really do anything. It's a 20-minute long video which mainly just consists of rambling and crying. I mean, I watched this whole video and there never really seemed to be that much of a point. It was just rambling. So anyway, let's see what kind of heinous crimes David Dobrik has committed.
Yeah, I don't think there should be a YouTuber out there that like ruins people's lives, like that literally, because like he messes with people for vlogs.
I think saying he ruins people's lives is a bit of a stretch. And by a bit of a stretch, I mean a bit fucking ridiculous. Like, he'll shoot a few of his mates with a paintball gun every now and then. But I've never seen him ruin anybody's life. Like, obviously, I don't see what goes on behind the scenes. But from what I've seen, he seems to be, like, a decent guy. Like, he buys his mates cars and stuff.
And I used to really love David. I used to think he was, like, so charming. In the same way Ted Bundy was charming. I guess, you know, everyone thought he was charming too.
What? Right, so you're comparing David Dobrik, big funny Vine man, to Ted Bundy, man who killed 30 people. Anyway, she ended up taking this video down not long after uploading it, probably because she realised that it was a bit fucking stupid. Like, I've only picked out 2 clips here because the video was so long and pretty pointless, and I didn't really want to have to go through the whole thing again. Yeah, anyway, guys, that's the end of today's video. I hope you did enjoy. I know I haven't uploaded in like a week, or it's been over a week now, and that's probably the longest I've gone without uploading for a while, and I'm sorry about that. Like, as I mentioned at the start of the video, my downstairs neighbors are literally trying to get me evicted at the moment. I don't know why they hate me so much. Like, it's almost every day at this point I have my building security come up to me and tell me to quieten down, even though nobody in the flat's making any noise. So I don't understand what's going on. Am I going to get evicted? Probably not, because most of the noise complaints coming in like the middle of the day for something stupid like dropping something on the floor. But okay, sorry, mate. I'll stop dropping things on the floor. But anyway, guys, as I said, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, be sure to subscribe and smash that like button.